Good evening, everyone. Wan Chang Hao. So many Chinese in the room, that's so nice. It's brilliant. Welcome to this evening to all of you, and to those of you who are watching online. I believe there's a couple of hundred online as well, which is super brilliant. I'm Farooq Chowdhury. I'm the artistic director of Fengling Productions, and we're absolutely thrilled to be here this evening co-hosting this event with the British Library, who've been very generous about giving us this incredibly privileged platform to present our work, or the work of Xiuhua. Fengling Productions, just so you get a bit of backstory, was founded 2 years ago by myself, and it was founded out of a passion, curiosity, and a fascination with working with Chinese artists and their stories, and finding ways that they could internationally collaborate with artists from the rest of the world to tell unusual and innovative stories. So that's really the purpose of it. And our vision is really simple. Our vision is beautiful things happen when different worlds meet. And so there are going to be many beautiful things happening this evening. So that's what Fengling Productions is about. But tonight is really all about Xiuhua herself, this unbelievably brilliant, profound woman and poet who has the most incredible poetic artistry. I first discovered her 6 years ago about reading about her in the New York Times. And when I read her poetry, I found words that spoke to my heart, to my head, and to my soul. And it made me think of a line. It was written in such an exquisitely simple but potent way, and it made me think of something that Leonardo da Vinci once said, that any form can be complicated, but it takes real genius to be simple. So this woman is a genius. And I think also what I find in her poetry is that you invites us to dream and reflect on the beauty and complexity and contradictory nature of what it means to be a human. So I'm truly grateful that I met her, and I'll tell you a little bit more about my first encounter. Now, I'm assuming that many of you know who she is, but for those who don't, if you could indulge me, I just want to read a little bit of her biography, just to give a bit of a backstory about you herself. So I have to get my tones right. I've been practicing all week, and I'm still rubbish. Xiuhua is a prominent Chinese poet who has gained significant recognition for a powerful and evocative poetry. Despite facing numerous challenges in her life, born on March the 28th, 1976, in Zhongxiang, Hubei Province, China, Yu has lived the majority of her life in a rural environment which has deeply influenced her work. Yu was born with cerebral palsy, a condition that affects muscle coordination and has made speaking and walking difficult for her. However, her physical limitations did not hinder her from expressing herself through writing. She began writing poetry in 1998, but it wasn't until 2014 that she gained national fame in China. Her poem, Crossing Half of China to Sleep with You, went viral on social media, touching on themes of desire, love, and the human condition, which resonated deeply with a wide audience, and I think particularly with young women. Despite her late rise to fame, Xiuhua has been prolific in her output, writing over 2,000 poems. Her candid and raw exploration of her life experiences, including her struggles with her disability, unfulfilled desires, and the stark realities of rural life, have made her work stand out in the contemporary Chinese literary scene. Yu's poetry collection, Moonlight Drops on My Left Hand, further solidified her status as a significant voice in modern Chinese literature. She has received numerous accolades for her contributions to poetry and has been featured in various media outlets, both within China and internationally. Xiuhua's life and work challenge societal norms and expectations surrounding disability, gender, and rural identity, making her an important figure in advocating for more inclusive and diverse representations in literature. Her personal story, marked by resilience and an unyielding passion for poetry, despite physical and societal barriers, has inspired many and brought to the fore the transformative power of literature. So that's Xiuhua in all her brilliance. Now, you may ask, how did we meet? Well, actually, I've been pursuing this woman for 6 years now, because I'm a dance producer, and as I said, Funglin Productions is about looking for unusual collaborations in dance, theatre, and music. And I really wanted to collaborate with her because I thought the poetry spoke to me. It made me learn a lot about who I am. And fortunately, there was a grant by the British Council last year which allowed me to have a conversation with her on Zoom and with her assistant, Oliver. And it was amazing. And all we talked about was shadows and her desire to learn to dance. So last year, we went to her village in Hung Dien in the summer with Suman Shu, who's our movement coach, and we found her movement language, and that led to her being involved in this production, 10,000 Tons of Moonlight, which I will tell you a little bit more about later. So that's really my encounter, and I'm truly grateful because since I've worked with her, she has thrown up a mirror to me to make me realize what I need to be a better human being. It's extraordinary learning from her. So what's going to happen this evening? This evening is made up of three events. The first part is a reading by Yu herself of three of her most celebrated poems, plus one, and including ones that she's chosen herself. And these will be interpreted after she's read them by an English actress, and she'll say those in English. After that, we will then have a small extract from our new production, 10,000 Tons of Moonlight, which is about 8 minutes long, which is a performance. And it's really a way of experiencing Yu's poetry through music and dance. That will be then followed by a conversation with Yu and the journalist and writer Yuan Yang, and with an interpreter and Oliver, which is Yu's assistant. And she would have an interview, and then we'll have a Q&A, and it will be ended with Yu giving a poem to all of you at the very end. What have I got to say? It's a bit long. But look, I needed to read this, actually. It's very important to me because my motivation to work with this amazing woman came from somewhere. And I read this in one of her books, and I really urge you to buy it. It's called Moonlight Rests on My Left Palm. And it includes poems and essays by Yu, which are absolutely unbelievable. But there's one particular extract that I want to share before I invite her to the stage. It's called The Swaying Mortal World. I have long believed that fatalism begins when you connect intimately with certain things and fall so hard in love with them that it becomes impossible for you to give them up. Take me, for instance. I love and suffer in poetry, rejoice over poetry while pursuing it, not to mention the untold dejection. Poetry connects my emotions in ways that nothing else can. I throw myself into life, persevere, and look forward to what lies ahead. I am grateful that poetry exists in my life. It presents me as I am. It shields me. Indeed, when I first sought to express my feelings through language, I chose poetry because of my cerebral palsy. Writing a word is strenuous for me. I must exert all my strength to balance my body, pressing my right wrist down with my left hand before struggling to get a word out. Among all literary genres, poetry uses the least amount of words. Naturally, it spoke best to me. Still, my first verses weren't exactly poetry. They merely allowed me to enjoy the pleasure of my favorite words. How overjoyed I was when I fulfilled an entire notebook with my distorted words. When I asked my teacher to take a look at my diary in verse, he replied in writing, "You're such a charming girl. The odds and ends of your life have turned into poetry." These simple words moved my heart. Having someone praise me as charming was all that I could ask for. I set out to keep this charm with me for all of my life. And sure enough, I have managed to do so. And on that note, I want to invite the most incredibly charming Xiuhua to the stage. I'd also like Tian to join, please. Yep. Thank you.
Yes. A pool of water. My favorite moment. Dusk darkens, night still young. My soul so clear, tumbling on a leaf. A lamp and shadow. I live naked. My shadow stretches itself, a segment kept to feed its silhouette. Water surges from everywhere and disperses everywhere. Softly I sway in water. Cream off the parts with luminous words onto the tips of grass. I like to be besieged by verses, to find a way out by working my heart out. Something loves me, it never leaves me. Yet it can't flow or find a summit in a song. Our goats are young, they're bleating soft. We are 100 steps away from summer fruits. In our lives, there will be many moments such as these, to see parts we ignore in ourselves.
初秋了，到这首的时候，秋风潺起，对你的爱是断绝一个黑色的星球，在宇宙深处，我无法完成一次爆破。我多么疲倦啊，爱和被爱都已呈现赫，我的眼睛是两个粉末，一个埋着细雨的火山，一个埋着绝望的死海。但是我要活着，胎死腹中般活着，像红狮子般。 占满秋天的山头，等你经过，都砸在你头上。你说不清自己的难处，你要记住我的身体就要从悬崖处经过。在枝头上荡漾的是昨晚的月亮，去年的月亮。 轮回的月亮，我希望你和我一起滚下去，从大广场上，从山坡上，从火焰上，我要我们一起烧得模糊，让性别成为爱情的对证。 把拳头打在鲜活的泥泞上，才能接住满山落叶。
Early autumn. When the rice ripens, that's when autumn winds begin. My love for you spirals into a black planet. Deep in the cosmos, I can't ignite a single explosion. How tired I am. To love and to be loved have become deep chasms. My eyes are two tombs. One buries a volcano of passion, the other a dead sea of despair. Yet I must live as if stillborn within the womb, like red persimmons crowning autumn's hills, waiting for you to pass by, to drop on your head. You can't tell where you came from. To enter my body, you'll have to pass by the cliff's edge. Swinging on the branches is last night's moon. It's last year's moon, the reincarnated moon. I force you to tumble down with me from the threshing ground, from the hillside, from flames. I want us to burn and blur together. Let sex incriminate us of love. Only by slamming our fists against life's sharp edge can we catch the fallen leaves covering the mountains.
You 我印悬崖上的树冠，但是与你依然有寂寞的呼声，顿时被捶打在峭晚的云朵，总是来不及爱，就已经深陷。你的名字被我咬出血，却没有打开幽暗的封印。 那些栖身的部分，让我停留。名叫黑蝴蝶，随你的倒影。我说：“你好，你们好，请接受我孤身一句的爱。”但是，我一次没有被迷惑，从来没有，如同河流。 在最深的夜里，也知道明天的去向。但是最后，我依旧无法原谅我自己，把你保留得如此完整。那些假象，你还是不知道的好啊！需要多少人间灰尘，才能掩盖住一个女子？
You didn't see the part of me being covered. In spring, I lift flower, fire, and the canopy of tree on the cliff. Yet the lonesome cool still echoes in the rain, thumping as a blunt tool onto the evening clouds. It's too late to love. I've already fallen for you. I bite your name until it bleeds. But still, I fail to break the dark seal. Only the easy parts can make me stay. Canna, black butterfly, and the reflection in the water. I say to them, hello, please accept my humble love as if I make a bow, but I have never been perplexed. Never. Just like a river, which knows the direction of tomorrow, even in the darkest night. But in the end, I can't forgive myself for keeping you so intact. It's better for you not knowing all those illusions. How many dusts in this world you will need to cover a woman's love that is bloody, yet glittering.
So now we're going to move to the performance element of this evening. Thank you so much. And Roger Gallo, who played the guitar, was exquisite and poetic and very fitting for the theme of this evening. So thank you, Roger, for your playing. So we've spent the last 3 weeks and 2 weeks last year working on a production called 10,000 Tons of Moonlight. Really, this is a dance theatre piece that takes its inspiration from the poetry of Xiuhua. And really what we're doing is we're exploring the themes of love, beauty, and what it means to live in a shadow. I won't say too much, but what we're going to do now is, in this small extract, which is about 8 minutes long, you'll experience three of the poems of you, and they're not going to be translated, so you're going to have to read the paper, but for the Chinese audience, that's probably fine, because you'll understand it. So, small extract from 10,000 Tons of Moonlight. Thank you.
Thank you.
他的四月条纹，白色的影子甩到汉江上，飞溅的水花落满蓝裙子。他在树影里看他，他从墨眼里取出一个支离破碎的自己，他从残疾里取出一个轻舞飞扬的自己，他在黑夜里跳舞，红色的影子甩到他面前，他从困顿里给他取出一个不停旋转的、不停旋转的自己。最好的时候是九月，影子回到他自己，小阴影回到月光里。
Do you think I'm beautiful? They say beauty can open doors, and it can give you a life of happiness and ease. But they never tell you that there's a price you pay, as if beauty alone can take away all suffering. You know, people call me beautiful, but I'm just the embodiment of their shallow dream, feeling as empty as the air around me. I need the sky to hold me and the flowers to make me perfect. And then I look at you. You're one of those birds flying in the sky above me, a bird with a broken body, but big, beautiful wings. But you don't need the sky to hold you, or the flowers to make you perfect. But I do. Sometimes I think my wings are broken. Like I'm trying to fly, but I can't quite let go. And where's the joy in a bird which can't use her wings?
I can't give my heart to you. 你也会疼，我不能把我的眼睛给你，怕我一流泪，你也会哭。我无法把我的命给你，因为我一死去，你也会消失。我要了你身后的位置，当我看你时，你就看不到我。我要了你夜晚的影子，当我喊你时，你听不到我。我要下了你的目的，从现在开始酿酒。
我是你，你是他，他们是我。 我是谁？你是余秀华。
Well, I enjoy watching that, and I've seen it countless times by now. It's a work in progress, and I hope that we will get to have the world premiere of this work in Shanghai in October this year, and then it will go on a world tour next year. So it's very beautiful and very touching and sincere. So I'm really proud of it, and I'm proud of what they did. Now, to move on to the third part of the evening, we're going to have a conversation with Xiuhua and led by Yuan Yang, who is a writer and a journalist. I just want to introduce her as well. So Yuan was born in 1990 in China, where she lived with her grandparents for 4 years before her parents brought her to the UK. She returned to China as an adult, posted there as a correspondent for the Financial Times. And she was one of the few journalists writing in English who left in the country. She later moved back to the FT's London headquarters as their first China-Europe correspondent. Next month, Yuan publishes her first book, Bloomsbury Private Revolutions, Coming of Age in a New China, published by Bloomsbury. I think the book you can buy outside, so I saw it out there. A book about the coming of age of four women born in China in the 1980s and 1990s and dreaming for better futures. We're lucky to have advanced copies on sale. I just mentioned it, on addition to used book outside. And also, I think it can be bought online via books tab for those of you who are watching online. So please, Yuan, welcome to the stage. You, Oliver, who's Yu's assistant, and Emma, who's going to be the interpreter. Thank you so much.
Well, it's lovely to be here, and I so enjoyed that dance performance. My first question for you, and I'll translate into Chinese as well, is when Jeannie and his team first approached you about this dance idea, what was your initial reaction?
我第一个问题是 Jeannie 和他的团队 第一是联系您关于这个舞蹈的演出，您的第一个反应是什么？这个问题是因为方可开始是找到小金花，小金花找到胡桃，然后我们在很长一段时间里在沟通这个事情，后来我觉得它是一种，也是一种。 新的尝试，可能第一是我觉得任何艺术都是相通的，可能对我来说是一种新的尝试，也是一种有一点挑战的，因为我也很喜欢那些新鲜的东西，所以就尝试着接受。
So first of all, I think Mr. Farouk found dancer Ji Lan and communicated for a long time about this new project. It is also a new thing for him to try as well. To me, I think that any forms of arts are sharing some similar special features and characteristics. It is a challenge to me, but I also love to challenge new things.
Do you feel that in the future you might experiment with different forms of creative expression, including dance and music and other forms? 您认为在未来您会继续探索这些不同的媒体，包括舞蹈、音乐等等吗？
媒体倒不会是我主动探的，这个因为现在舞蹈和美术、画画我都在慢慢的一个慢慢的尝试和过程中，但是我这个人是比较懒惰和被动的一个人，我就。
I don't think I'm going to proactively challenge any new things, although I'm in the slow progress of learning how to dance and paint. But I'm quite a lazy and laid-back person. If someone guides me and lead me, I'd love to try, but not by myself.
不好意思。So maybe in a few years' time we'll have your painting exhibition also in London. 希望接下来这几年会再次欢迎您来伦敦参加你的 painting
的画展的。哦，这个，我没有这个可能，现在就不要谈这个。
I don't think that's possible. Please don't think about it.
I have a question about your various poetry collections over time. How do you feel your poetry has changed over time, over the many collections you've published? 您觉得您在您的诗歌写作的前后，随着时间有没有什么不同的变化？您从前和现在出版的诗歌集。
写作上有什么不同？如果说到底有什么不同，我是说不出来很具体的一个事，也许它的改变就在不知不觉之中。诗歌它是人的心理和灵魂的一个体现，它必定会随着你的成长。 随着你的心境在流转，所以，可能我以后写的诗歌，我希望更多的对于这个世界的思考，对于这个社会的思考，我希望是多一点，不要像以前那么恋爱脑。虽然补充一句。
I think it will be hard for me to say anything specific, what kind of changes have there been. But I think those changes are made without me sensing it. It grows with my heart and soul through time. I think maybe in the future, I would like to focus more on the reflections of the world and the society, maybe slightly less about love, since I used to be a lovehead. Although I have to say that I think lovehead is supposed to be a positive word, a compliment.
Well, I have to ask as a follow-up to that question, what has changed to make you less of a lovehead? Now, 您为什么现在对恋爱没有像之前那么感兴趣呢？我老了。Because
I'm getting old.
我更年轻了，同志们，我更年轻了，没有那么追求。I'm
getting to that age when women start to throw temper.
So over time, you know, over your teenage years, your 20s, your 30s, and so on, when do you think were the peaks and lows of your interest in love?
就是从比如说少年到二十年初三十岁等等，您觉得您对恋爱的兴趣有什么不同的波动和变化？以前吧都没有什么波动，没就是以前的岁月，就是我两年之前，甚至说。 从1年之前开始没有波动，就是一个 见谁都想恋爱的那种，就觉得自己想证明我是可以有爱，我是值得被爱的，我是觉得自己一直在追求我是值得被爱的这个过程，所以一直在不断的寻求证明。到现在我觉得这个东西我不需要证明，我觉得我自己值得被我自己爱。 就OK， 当我爱自己的时候，全世界都是爱我的。Actually,
I don't think there had been much ups and downs in my love life in the past. Just until 1 year ago, I think I've been trying so hard to seek being loved because I believe that seek someone to love me proves that I'm worthwhile to be loved. But now I changed. I don't think I need to prove that I'm valuable, that I'm worthy to be loved. As long as I love myself, I believe and I feel the whole world loves me.
Thank you. So I think probably speaking for myself, many in the audience are not yet at your stage in the journey and are still seeking love. What changed for you to transition from the seeking love to the self-love? 我感觉很多今晚参加的贵宾和我自己都可以说，我们还没有经历过您刚才提到的这个过程。没有啊，对，你就说你还没有到更年期。<laughs>
Don't worry, that just means that you're not up to the age to throw your temper at yet.
Now, apart from menopause, what else do you think would change to cause this change in self-reflection? 除了更年期以外，有没有其他的心理上的变化，让你对就是改变你对恋爱的态度？其实要说改变嘛，我可能真正改变的部分。
不是很多，只是现在在这个还不算寂寞，不算孤独的阶段，我才觉得爱情不是那么必须。而且通过上一段的感情，我对两性之间，或者说人性，就是人的本性，有了很多直观的。 了解和直观的思考，我觉得恋爱是爱情是一个非常宝贵的东西，它和月亮一样，有时候是可望而不可求的。你们好多人都没有爱情，凭什么我有，对不对？<笑>
I don't think there has been much significant changes. And I'm still not in the period to feel isolated or lonely yet. So I don't think love is a must thing in my life. Plus, that I've witnessed directly of the past generations, my parents, my grandparents' generations, how the men and women relationships are. And I've observed and reflected much on the human nature. And so I think that love is something rather precious. Sometimes it's as precious and far away like the moon. And even not all of you have love. Why must I?
So do you think love is something that is very commonplace? Or do you think it's actually very rare and exotic? 你觉得真正的恋爱是个非常普遍的一个事情吗？还是其实非常稀罕？
你为什么对这个问题这么……难道你对你的爱情有所怀疑？不是真爱吗？为什么对这个问题这么感兴趣呢？他肯定没有得到过爱情，不是怀疑。
I'd like to ask that, do you think love is a rare thing and why do you think so? And the answer is...
I'm sorry.
I don't know why you are so stumping with this question. Do you think love is so do you think love is not something precious and Or are you in a period that's lacking of love?
不是，我觉得我是一个爱情的失败者。你们老是向我取经，我真的是一个反面教材。我不。
And I think that I am not a winner in love life, and you ask for my experience and suggestion, that's asking the wrong person.
part of me wants to ask the audience how many would identify with that last statement. But我有点想感兴趣问一下观众，有谁也认为自己也是爱情的失败者？
Don't raise your hand, don't. If you raise your hand, you admit you're a loser, but you are not a loser.
Okay, I have one last question on the theme of love. 在这个话题有最后一个问题。 Your poems in your latest collection, your most famous poems, are often talking about unrequited love. Do you think unrequited love is more interesting as a topic to write about than satisfied love? 您这里的诗歌，包括您最著名的一首诗歌，都是在谈远离或者无可回报的爱情。那您认为无可回报的爱情比令人欣慰的爱情更有意思吗？
你为什么觉得我的爱情都是没有回报的呢？
Why do you assume that all my love relationship is unrequited?
我觉得我的爱情都有回报。
I think all my love has been answered.
爱主者爱反，我爱他的时候就是爱者回报我。Because
when I love someone, I already got the reward of being loved.
I think you've given us a lot to think about. 我感觉你给了我们很多可以再反思的话题。哎呀，这反思也太……That's
too serious. Be relaxed, please. Don't broadcast that.
Okay, so going back to the title of your latest collection, The Writing in the Clouds, Living in the Earth, the title speaks to this tension between everyday practical life and this imaginative intellectual life. And do you feel like there are ever times in your life when you are too in the clouds or on the earth? And how do you find the balance between the two?
现实型的生活与理想的精神材质型的生活的冲突，那您在自己的生活中是否感觉到有某些时候身在云端，和某些时候身在地上？您怎么样在两者之间获得平衡？其实这个需要解释一下。 我从来不觉得我的生活在云里或者是在云里，只是有时候觉得一个人的精神状态，就是那种精神生活。比如说，当我以前是因为婚姻觉得痛苦，觉得婚姻是一个泥潭的时候，我才想要逃离。 有婚姻的生活状态，但是我现在觉得我挺好。我现在还生活在农村，我的老家，不是在大城市，但是我自己觉得我很满意，很幸福，也很知足，所以并不觉得我在偏远的农村，我就会觉得生活不如意。就是人，我。 人之所以痛苦，并不是因为你住的条件，或者有时候因为你没有钱什么的，更多的是因为你的精神的追求，包括恋爱也是属于精神追求，你的
I have to explain a little bit into that. I've never felt I've been living in the mud, on the earth, or in the cloud. It's always somewhere in between. Because I think what decides whether you are happy or not is more about your spiritual world. In the past, when I was in a terrible marriage, when I feel that the life is terrible made by the marriage, I wanted to escape from it. But now, I feel content. I'm still living in my hometown in the rural area of China, but I feel satisfied, happy, and content. It doesn't make me sad just because I'm living in a rural area, and I don't think your living condition or how much money you have is the deciding reason for any human beings to feel sad. I think it's more about the gap, the huge gap between what you're seeking for spiritually and what kind of reality you're living in. And when I stopped seeking blindly for love, I feel happy and content. He understands me.
And you talk about this gap between your desire and reality, which to me sounds like a very Buddhist concept. Are you at all influenced by Buddhist literature or Buddhist poetry? Can you keep on with that?
刚才您说的一些精神方面的追求，我觉得听起来很像是佛教的一些追求。那您个人在生活中也是佛教徒吗？
不，我应该这样说，我既是佛教徒，也是基督教徒。
Well, I should say that no, but yes, maybe I am a Buddhist, I'm a Christian, I'm not any kind of religious person, you can call me that.
我觉得人呢，就是人的对那个的信仰，他不分这个那个，就是人对天地，我们说的信仰、佛教或者什么的，都是。 对天地、对人、对事物的一种敬畏之心，它无化成那个佛或者上帝其实一样的意思。And
to me, I believe that human beings should keep a respectful eye and mind to the heaven and earth. And as long as you are faithful towards that, it doesn't really matter which religion you believe.
So tonight is the premiere of this dance production and also the launch of your English language translation. Is this your first time coming to the UK? How is it going? How's your trip going? Oh, sorry.
我知道今天晚上呢是我们首次发布关于您参加的舞剧《万吨月色》，也是您的这个诗集的英译版销售的这个时候。那么这也是据我所知您第一次出访英国，想问一下您这一次出访英国的体验如何？因为这是我来英国和这么多的朋友一起跳舞。
主要是跳舞，和那个新书市的国内出的，所以这是我还是觉得到英国来，就去的三个地方都是怎么样，怎么把瓜花式的伦敦，什么，纽卡斯尔，纽卡斯尔，纽卡斯尔，纽卡斯尔很爱丁堡，去爱丁堡我们就逛了一天，其实这三个城市都是很美的城市，但是别的地方我不知道，给我的感觉，还是挺好的。
This time, my main focus is to dance with my friends, so just dance. And then the new book was published in China. That was not really my focus. And my experience to the UK, I only visited three cities, London, Newcastle, and Edinburgh. We only stayed in Edinburgh for one day, but all these three cities are beautiful. As for other places in the UK, I don't know, because I've never been there. Okay. But I'm very happy with my visit.
You're very welcome to come to my hometown in Reading. 也欢迎你来到我的老家是 Reading.
你的老家不是中国吗?
I thought your hometown is China.
Do you think somebody can have more than one hometown? 那你认为一个人可以有更多老家吗?
当然可以.
Of course you can.
那您有几个老家? How many hometowns do you have?
我的老家就是中国呀。
Just one, China.
在横店，湖北。 China湖北。
横店 village, 湖北, China.
我现在还没有条件出国嘞，是吧? 到时候再说。
Sorry, none of us picked that up. I didn't say anything, just ignore it.
So speaking of the UK, what would you like a British audience who may have never been to China or seen the farmland that you describe to take from your poetry? 您是个的英国受众。
或许从来没有去过中国，或者没有去过描述的乡村生活。您希望他们从您的诗歌获得什么？我写我的诗歌，我从来没有说想我的读者在我的诗歌里获得我想知道的那部分没有。我觉得阅读是千姿百态的。 阅读和作者没有很大的关系，就是一千个阅读者有一千个理解方式和阅读方法，取决于读者本身对世界的看法、对情感的理解角度，他和我的关系不大。我在任何地方都强调这个话，当然我希望英国的读者。 更多的理解中国汉语的语言美，这可能是因为我也不懂英文，因为他们两者之间的可比性我也不懂，反正我觉得汉语很美，就是这样。
I have never thought about what I want my readers to take away or achieve from my poems. That's not what I think when I create poems. And I think there 1,000 readers, there in 1,000 readers' eyes, there will be 1,000 different versions of Hamlet. And how they understand my poems is depending on their perspective of the world and how they understand love. So that's something I always stress. I do not wish to connect readers with my creation too tightly. As for my UK readers, I think, just because I don't know any English, so I think that I would like my English readers to appreciate the beauty and lyrical rhythm of Chinese, because I think Chinese is a beautiful language.
鼓掌的男的都是中国人吗?
是。 Are all the audience Chinese? Are all my UK readers Chinese too?
好好开玩笑，开玩笑。我们也有外国的。 谢谢外国的友人们。
Thank you, all my non-Chinese audience and readers.
有没有英国的帅哥?
Is there any handsome, charming English gentleman here? Please. Didn't you just say you are not seeking love anymore? I just said I'm not interested in seeking love, but I never said I'm not interested in seeking men.
If you meet the right English lad like me, you can have two hometowns.
您要是遇到一个对的英国人，您就可以有第二个家乡了。哟，这个好人呐！ That is great.
我很难搞定的，英国人搞不定我。
But I am a difficult woman. It takes some challenge for an English lad to get me down.
So I have.
Hold it back a little bit.
I.
Why are we back to the topic about love and relationship again?
I have one last question before we open up to questions from the floor, so please prepare some questions. Were you ever surprised by the fame that your poetry has brought you, and why do you think so many readers have connected to your writing? 您是否对您诗歌带来的巨大声誉感到惊讶吗? 而且你认为为什么有如此多的读者?
关注和关联您的诗歌呢？被您的诗歌触动。嗯。呀，这英国就是还有的什么？其实，你不要这。Don't
distract me.
看看我的花费。 其实我就开个玩笑，你别当真了，真的是。别在旁边说，嗯。
I'm just making a joke. Don't take it seriously.
我其实从我开始出版诗歌到现在，我从来不觉得我获得了多大的名气，本来我这个人是嘴太直，就是。 有坏的名声，也有好的名声。这个名声对一个真正的写作者，他这是外部条件的。我觉得一个诗人或者说一个写作者是不应该为名利所累。不过我现在不知道我有没有为名利所累，这个我也不知道。嗯。
Ever since I started to write poems till now, I don't really think I have gained any significant fame. I am a very direct person, and I reflect that in my poems as well. So I think I've gained bad names and some good reputation as well. But to me, I think fame or not, those are external conditions to a writer, and a writer shouldn't be influenced by that, although I'm not sure if I have been influenced by them so far.
So now we're going to open to questions from the floor.
现在是结束。Oh,
my second question just now was what do you think has led so many readers to connect with your work?
您觉得为什么那么多读者都能够被您的诗歌触动？这个你得问他们呢。 That is a question you should ask my readers.
我不知道。
I have no idea.
Well, now we can ask the audience who have all come tonight
to hear you. 你问他为什么喜欢我，我怎么知道他喜欢我了，对不对？
I should ask my readers here today why you like my poems.
Do we have a roving mic to go around the floor with? Yes, we've got a mic at the back, so let's take the lady over here, and then there's one there as well, and then we'll go to the lady right over there. So one here, one in the middle, and one over there.
那个于老师你好，然后刚刚话头已经到说为什么被您的诗触动，我一开始被您诗触动，主要是两年前看您的公众号，然后那段时间您写了很多热恋的诗，然后那段时间我也在热恋期间，但是我想问的不是这个，因为现在两年多了，我这段感情也走到了结尾。我就想说，第一个问题我是想问于老师，我想说，就是你会不会？ 在非这种公开的表演的时间，再会就是回看过去写的诗，然后你回看的时候会觉得说，哇，我真是个天才，还是觉得啊那个时候是有点年轻了，然后第二个问题是想问于老师，今天介绍的项目是又跟舞蹈相关，又跟诗歌相关，然后我旁边这位是我很好的朋友，他那天拉着我在一个。 Silas Wells 是吗？现代舞剧团，然后他拉着我围绕着一个中年女人来来回回走了六七圈，就是想确定是不是您，我就替他问一下，那天在那个剧院的会是您吗？我就这两个问题，谢谢。不是，
那肯定不是我。I'll translate this answer to the second question first. That's definitely not me. The first question is. I've started, the question asked first is that about 2 years ago, I started to read the poems you posted on your public account on the social media. I was in a relationship back then, so, and your poems really touched me because they are passionate love poems as well. Although now, 2 years later, my relationship ended. My question is, when you look back to the previous poems you wrote, will you think, that, oh, I'm really such a genius, or you will think that those poems are still quite young and has many rooms for improvement. The second question is just trying to figure out if they have met Miss Yu the other day at a modern dance performance site.
Not, 他们觉得我是天才吧，是吧？
问您是否会回看之前你自己的诗的时候，觉得自己是个天才？哎，
我其实我所有的爱情诗歌，那些具体的和不具体的对象，都不怎么高大上。<笑> 但是当我回看诗歌的时候，我觉得唯一他们留给我的遗产就是我的诗歌。
Actually, regarding all my previous poems, especially poems about love, written for some specific men or men in general, I would have to say that those men, when I wrote those poems thinking of, are not any decent person. But I think they did leave me some precious heritage, which are my poems.
还有一句话，天才从来不会觉得自己是天才。And
another answer to...
谁会觉得自己是天才的？不可能的嘛，真的是。<laughs>
Another answer to that question is, we never seen any real genius think themselves as genius. But I know that, except Einstein, I think he knows he's a genius.
Okay, so the second question was over here.
你好，于老师。其实我就是首先表达一下我对你的喜爱，因为我之前在来之前看了你非常多的那个采访和纪录片，我觉得就是今天现场看到你和你之前在纪录片里展现的其实是非常，就是相似的，然后就是没有什么区别。其实我还挺惊讶的，因为我觉得能就是直接比较真实的展现在媒体面前，其实。 还是挺少见的，是一个非常有勇气的事情。然后我的问题是因为我之前看您的诗歌，就是之前几年的，您的灵感来源于更多的是精神方面，就是爱情之类的，就作为一个灵感来源。但是你今天说，可能说你这一年，就是说自己爱自己，不再去寻求其他人来爱你这些事情。那我在想，你之后写作的时候会。 就是在这个追求精神层面的这个诗歌方面，会就是搜寻
友情或者是家庭成员之间的这种亲情吗？就是作为自己写作的一个灵感来源，而不是爱情这样。
First of all, I'd like to express how happy and also slightly surprised to have meeting you today. I've watched many interviews and documentaries about you before coming to this event, and I'm surprised to see that you act completely the same as in those interviews, which I think takes a lot of courage for people to behave themselves as truly and honestly in front of the camera and in real life. But my question is that you mentioned now you start to seeking to love yourself rather than seeking to be loved by the others. So in the future, are you going to focus more on the topics of friendship and family's love for your poem?
其实我在以往的诗歌里写亲情也有，但是没有爱情那么多，可能是亲情一直在滋养着我，不管我在哪里，他们都是我的一座靠山，所以有一种情怀是你放在这，你永远知道它的存在，你就不会的去格外的追求他，去要求他。我想诗歌就是写的，不一定要强调的是你一定是围绕爱情、围绕亲情，或者围绕哪一份的感情。我觉得诗歌是自然生发的，它可能是我今天看到这棵树，看到这朵花，看到这个人，是一瞬间的感受，也是你所有在世界上行走的过程里一种感受，一种思考积累到一个点的一个爆发点，它并不会专门围绕着哪一样感情来写。
My past poems also have some of them focusing on family's love, although not as much as men and women love. I think the love for and from my family nurtures me all the time. They are the mountain that I can rely on when I feel tired and when I look back. So I don't think we have to, or I have to seek to write a particular kind of love or any kind of relation, emotion in my poem. Because I think poem is something created spontaneously. For example, if I see a tree or a flower or just the cloud in the sky today, for that very moment, if they inspire me to feel something, to feel a kind of passion or emotion, I could write about them. I think a poem is more about the process of life, the walk of life, any feelings you have, any reflections or thoughts at a certain moment. It doesn't have to be about relationships or love of any kind.
Go to the woman in the green top over there.
Xiuhua, 你好，就是
叫我Xiuhua这么亲热的吗？
我不想叫你老师，是因为我觉得我和你之间的连接非常的深。我六七年前就知道你，然后今天你开始念诗的时候，我就开始哭，是因为我为你感到高兴。就是因为当时看采访的时候，你还坐在轮椅上，是那样一个状态。
我什么时候坐过轮椅啊？
对不起，那可能是我记错了。
我知道嘞。
好，对不起，是我记错了。OK，
那是在苏州的那个可能喝醉的酒。
OK， 那可能
他说我坐轮椅，我没坐过。
对不起，那可能是我记错了。
喝醉酒坐过轮椅，
那其实太久之前的事情。然后，但是就是过了很久，然后今天看到你在跳舞，你在念诗，然后你来英国，你还说你在尝试绘画的时候，我就特别的为你感到高兴，所以我就开始不停的哭。
画画是吹牛了
啊！不要紧啦。
画了两幅。
但是我是真的，就是 很为你感到高兴，可以走到这么多地方然后去看。嗯，然后还有一个问题就是跟诗歌没有关系，就是问想知道你喜不喜欢吃西餐，你想不想就是在伦敦多待的时候看一下 Magical Mac 那个就是一群肌肉男然后在你面前秀的一个很
有吗
有。
So I've started to read and follow you on social media and documentaries, interviews since six or seven years ago. So I'd like to call you by your name rather than call you with the title teacher or professor. And I know that when I saw you today reading your poems, dancing, and mentioned about you're going to do painting as well, I can't help but started crying because I feel so happy for you. And my question is not anything to do with your poems. I just want to ask, number one, if you like British food, and number two, do you think you will ever pay a visit to Magic Mike in the city center? They are all like very masculine, handsome men naked dancing to you.
我
来解释一下，他是想问你，一个是喜不喜欢西餐，第二个是
有没有，不是西餐，就是西外国男人的意思。
So let me interpret the British food. I mean Magic Mike.
我想问的是，就是你有没有机会，想不想去伦敦市中心看一个表演叫魔法六，就是 Magic Mike 魔法麦克，他是那个非常帅的肌肉猛男，脱了衣服跳舞。
每天都有这个票，每天都有。
明天有吗？
They sell tickets every day, even tomorrow.
反正我后天就回国了。
But I have to go back to China the day after tomorrow.
明天就去。
Then go
tomorrow. 那你跟我去。
I'll take you there.
不是，那就来看还是可以的，就是
可以摸的。
你这个问题啊，问的真不是时候。
I don't think it's a good timing for that question.
恰好这个阶段我对他没有什么担心。
I think I'm right in the moment of losing some interesting men now.
而且你想想，那个小男孩子会对我一个老太婆感兴趣吗？你想过没有？
Maybe you should consider whether Magic Mike would be interested in an old woman like me.
我们付出是要回报的。
We for anybody to give out something, they ask for something back.
I think not everything needs to be translated.
At this point, I don't know if the British Library are going to have us back or have any of you back.
别问了，这个问题别再问了，好俗气的问题。我就是个俗人。
Maybe I sound a bit kitschy, but I am a kitschy person.
对。
I think we had a question down here at the front. Okay, let's take up here and then down at the front. Yeah.
I'd like to know if you read the writings and poetry of any non-Chinese poets or writers, and if so, what do you think is the difference, the main difference between Chinese writing and non-Chinese writing, and also which non-Chinese writers do you like and poets do you like?
想问一下，您是否有阅读过非中国人的作家的诗或者是书籍，如果有的话，您觉得最大的区别是什么？以及您最喜欢的外国作家是谁？
就是因为我读外国作品读的还挺多的，包括沃尔克他的诗歌啊，和那个悲惨，就是俄国的那个。不是，不是，不是，实际还有个 小说家是那个小说家，托老托，是也不知道是谁。反正我的确是看过很多外国的照片，我唯一的遗憾是他们的名字我忘了是什么是字是谁。的确，他们很多，因为我虽然写诗歌，但是我读的更多的是小说和随笔和传记。 诗歌我读了，反而是比较少的一部分。这两年跟着我伟大的朋友，读到了一些好的诗歌。以前是，那些小说，比如托斯耶夫托斯基，很多小说我都是读过，非常喜欢，就是。
俄国的、英国的，还有别的国家的小说，我读了很多。胡笑山庄还有个叫什么？胡笑山庄，他的姐妹写的那个叫，都读过，但是我更喜欢的是胡笑山庄，写的特别好。I have actually read many novels or biographies from non-Chinese writers, maybe not so much, so many poems, but my great friend here, sitting next to me, he always tell me a lot about the foreign writers' poems he loves. I have to say that I read many novels written by non-Chinese writers, such as Dostoevsky, and writers from the UK or Caribbean countries, and I love them so much. My favorite British author, British writers' novels are Wuthering Heights and also Jane Eyre.
I know there are many more questions left, but we want to give the last words to Xiuhua, of course, so I'm going to close with her, a poem from her.
What? No gentleman.
No gentleman.
我知道大家可能还有很多很多的问题想问，但是因为时间的关系，我最后想要把时间交回给余秀华的一首诗。我想用余秀华女士的一首诗来结束今天的问答。哎呀，终于结束了！<笑>啊，我要读最后一首诗歌是每个春天。 我都会唱歌，因为现在是春天了嘛，不唱歌就不好。<笑>每个春天我都会唱歌，每个春天我都会唱歌，看云朵从南来，风正轻一点就是真正的春天了。 一个人在田埂上，蒲公英怀抱着小小的火焰，在春天里奔跑，一直跑到村外。而我的歌声，他是听不到的。我总想给他打电话，我有许多话没说。一朵花。 开的时间太短，一个春天驻足的日子太少。他喊我听不清楚，听不清楚。他听不清楚一个老太人口齿不清的表白。那么多人经过春天，那么多花再打开，他猜不出。 我在说什么？但是每个春天，我都会唱歌，歌声在风里摇曳的样子，忧伤又甜蜜。谢谢。谢谢。谢谢。
Leonardo da Vinci.
forgot to say that genius comes with a great sense of humour. So thank you so much. That was absolutely enjoyable, even in the English language. It's really important that we get your feedback. You know, we do these things for you. And it's important to know how you felt, what you took away from the experience. So please, at the end of your sheet of paper, there's an email or someplace that you can write back and tell us what this experience meant to you. It's very important to us that you do that. Okay, and I need to thank a few people. I want to thank the Fengling team. They've been unbelievable. I want to thank the people at the British Library, the technical team, the sound, the lighting people. They've done an extraordinary job in such a short space of time. And most of all, I want to thank you for her incredible humanity and how she makes us laugh and think and reflect and just remind us how wonderful it is to be a human being, really. So thank you. And I suppose the thing about love, it's like those four words we use in our lives every single day. Love, hope, trust and faith. And we use these words almost repeatedly every day. And the funny thing is, I suppose we can't really describe what they really mean. But we certainly know when they're not there. So let's just remind ourselves about that. Thank you so much for coming out. It's been a brilliant evening.
Oh, 就是余秀华其实很久已经没有跟大家没有出新书了，他那个现在的诗集还是以前的诗集，但是我们有一个好消息，是他可以宣布了哈。四月底即将发行他的第四部个人诗集《后山开花》，然后所以在五月份我们可能会。 大规模的宣传吧，然后老余也会参加各样的活动，各种各样的活动，然后希望大家去读到他的诗，这本书出来非常不容易，所以希望大家多多支持，谢谢。I'd like to make
an announcement. Although Xiuhua hasn't been creating any new poems for some time, but the good news is we're going to publish a new collection of her new poems by the end of April, and we're going to market about it in May. So please keep an eye on it.